नीट 2020 केमिस्ट्री पेपर एक्सप्लेनेशन कोड G4 क्वेश्चन नंबर 136 द गिवन रिएक्शन इज हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ सुक्रोज इज गिवन बाय द फॉलोइंग रिएक्शन सुक्रोज ऑन रिएक्शन विथ वाटर प्रोड्यूसेस ग्लूकोज एंड फ्रक्टोज इफ इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट केसी फॉर दिस रिएक्शन इज 2 × 10^13 at 300 Kelvin. The value of delta G naught at the same temperature will be. Delta G naught is given by the expression minus RT into natural logarithm of equilibrium constant. Here the units are discussed in the SI units. Now the value of R is to be taken as 8.314. Temperature is to be taken as 27 degrees centigrade, that is 300 Kelvin, into natural logarithm of equilibrium constant, and its value is 2 × 10^13. No necessity of substitution, so the option is fourth option. Next, question number 137. Which of the following has maximum number of atoms? Maximum number of atoms. Let us consider number of atoms is given by the formula weight of the element in grams divided by gram atomic weight of the element. Gram atomic weight of the element. Into Avogadro's number. The value of Avogadro number and weight is same for all the elements. And the given elements are magnesium, whose atomic weight is taken as 24. And next one is oxygen, whose atomic weight is taken as 16. Next one is lithium, whose atomic weight is taken as 7. And the next one is silver, whose atomic weight is 108. Now, weight is same for all the elements. Avogadro's number n is also same for all elements. Now, the element that is having lowest atomic weight, lowest gram atomic weight, has maximum number of atoms. Now, lithium, whose atomic weight is equal to 7, which has maximum number of atoms. Next, question number 138. Let us take the question. Which of the following is not correct about carbon monoxide? If we consider carbon monoxide and oxygen, out of these two, carbon monoxide strongly bonded to hemoglobin. Whereas when compared to carbon monoxide, oxygen weakly bonded to hemoglobin. So that carboxyhemoglobin is more stable than oxyhemoglobin. Now in the option, second option, carboxyhemoglobin is less stable than oxyhemoglobin. So this is the wrong statement. So the correct option is second option. Next, question number 139. Calculated spin-only magnetic moment of Cr2+ ion is. Let us consider chromium, whose atomic number is 24. And electronic configuration of chromium is argon 4s1 3d5. Cr2+ ion means chromium atom has to lose 2 electrons. Now, out of those 2 electrons, 1 electron was lost from 4s subshell and another electron lost from 3d subshell. And the configuration of Cr2 plus ion becomes argon 3d4. In argon, all the electrons are paired up. Now what about the distribution of 4 electrons in d subshell? According to above principle, those 4 electrons are existing as single electrons. Now there is a presence of 4 unpaired electrons in Cr2 plus ion. Now spin only magnetic moment is given by the formula mu is equal to root over n into n plus 2 Bohr magnetons, where n is number of unpaired electrons. Here in Cr2 plus ion, 4 unpaired electrons are present. Now spin only magnetic moment is root over 4 into 4 plus 2 Bohr magnetons, that is equal to root 24 Bohr magnetons, that is equal 4.9 Bohr magnetons. So next, next question number 140. Which of the following is a natural polymer? Let us consider natural rubber, which is a natural polymer. This natural rubber is a polymer. Monomer of natural rubber is cis 1,4 isoprene. Cis 1,4 isoprene is the monomer of natural rubber, so that cis 1,4 polyisoprene, it is to be considered as a natural polymer. Next question number 141. Which of the following is basic amino acid? If we consider lysine, in the structure of lysine, there is a presence of two NH2 groups and one COOH group. Since it contains more number of NH2 groups, now this lysine is to be considered as basic amino acid. Next question number 142. A mixture of nitrogen and argon gases in a cylinder contains 7 grams of nitrogen and 8 grams of argon. If the total pressure of the mixture of gases in the cylinder is 27 bar, then the partial pressure of nitrogen is. First of all, we have to find number of moles of nitrogen. Formula for number of moles is weight in grams divided by gram molecular weight. Now, weight of nitrogen was given as 7 grams. Gram molecular weight is 28 grams. Now that is equal 0.25 moles is number of moles of nitrogen. Next, number of moles of argon. Weight of argon is given as 8 grams and its gram molecular weight is 40 grams. Now, number of moles of argon is equal to 0.2. Now, total number of moles is equal to number of moles of nitrogen plus number of moles of argon, that is equal 0.25 plus 0.2, that is equal 0.45. Now the final question is, what is the partial pressure of nitrogen? Partial pressure of nitrogen is equal number of moles of nitrogen divided by total number of moles into total pressure. Now number of moles of nitrogen 0.25, total number of moles are 0.45, and the total pressure is given as 27 bar and the simplified value is 15 bar. So partial pressure of nitrogen is 15 bar. Thank you. Next question number 143. Paper chromatography is an example of, it is to be considered as an example of partition chromatography. So direct concept. So the option for this question is first option. Next, let us consider question number 144. The given reaction is two chlorine atoms combines together to form Cl2 gas. Chlorine atoms are present in the gaseous state and the former chlorine molecule also present in the gaseous state. The question is, what about the delta H and delta S values for this reaction? Formation of a chemical bond is exothermic in nature. So that heat energy is liberated in this process. So delta H assigns the negative sign. Now what about the change in entropy? Here the atoms are present in a more disordered manner. Entropy is more. Whenever the two chlorine atoms combines together, disorderness somewhat decreases. Disorderness of the product is less. Disorderness of the reactants is more. So the symbol is nothing but negative. Delta H assigns the negative sign. Delta S also assigns the negative sign. Then the correct option is third option. One forty-five. Right, question number 145. Urea reacts with water to form A, which will decompose to form B. B, when passes through Cu2 plus ions, deep blue color solution was formed. What is the formula of C from the following? When urea was dissolved in water and after decomposition, ammonia is obtained. Now, Cu2 plus ion combines with ammonia molecules, leading to the formation of a complex compound, which is CuNH3 taken 4, carries 2 units of positive charges. Here, coordination number of copper is 4. Ammonia is a neutral molecule, so this is the correct representation for the complex compound. And this one is having deep blue color. Now, the option is to be considered as first option. Next, question number 146. On electrolysis of dilute sulfuric acid using platinum electrodes, the product obtained at anode will be. Now let us consider. If H2SO4 undergoes ionization, the products produced are H plus and SO42 minus. It is an aqueous solution. From aqueous solution, let us imagine that there is a production of H plus ions and OH minus ions. Now, at cathode, H plus ions will be reduced. As a result of that, hydrogen gas is the product at cathode. But here the question is, what about the reaction at anode? Now, OH minus ion competes with SO42 minus ion. Preferential discharge is more for OH minus ion. OH minus ions requires less energy for their oxidation at anode. So OH minus ions undergoes oxidation at anode. Now, it is better to consider water undergoes oxidation at anode to produce O2 as the product along with the formation of 4H plus ions. If water undergoes oxidation in this case, the product obtained at anode is O2 gas. And the answer is first option. Next, question number 147. An element has body-centered cubic structure with a cell edge of 288 picometers, the atomic radius is. In case of body-centered cubic structure, the relation between edge length and the radius. In BCC structure, the atoms which are present along body diagonal touches with one another. Now, there are four radius are there. That is equal to root 3 into A. Now, radius is equal to root 3 by 4 into edge length. Now, root 3 by 4, edge length was given as 288 picometers. No necessity of simplification because the option is directly given as fourth option. Next, question number 148. If concentration of the reactants increases, now, concentration of reactants increases means number of reacting molecules per unit volume increases. Number of molecules per unit volume increases. Unit volume increases. As a result of that, number of collisions that are taking place in unit time increases. Number of collisions taking place in unit time increases. So that is nothing but collision frequency increases. Now the option is third option. Next, question number 149. Which of the following alkane cannot be made in good yield by Wood's reaction? One of the drawback of the Wood's reaction is alkane containing odd number of carbon atoms cannot be obtained in pure state. Now this is the drawback of the Wood's reaction. So among the given options, N-heptane, which contains 7 carbon atoms, that is odd number of carbon atoms, which cannot be obtained in good yield. Now question number 150. Identify the correct statement. Identify incorrect statement among the given compounds. Let us consider CrO4 2-. Another one is Cr2O7 2-. Here oxidation number of chromium is nothing but, let us consider oxidation number of chromium as X. 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2. By simplifying this, oxidation number of chromium is plus 6. Now here, oxidation number of chromium is to be taken as X, 2 into X, plus 7 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2. 2X minus 14 is equal to minus 2. By simplifying this, we are getting plus 6 is the oxidation number of chromium. In both the species, oxidation number of chromium is plus 6. But here the third, if we consider the third option, the oxidation state of chromium in CrO4 2- and Cr2O7 2- is not same, so that it is incorrect statement. So the option is third option. Next, question number 151. Which of the following is a cationic detergent? Now let us consider, if we consider the second option, cetyl, trimethyl, ammonium bromide, cetyl, trimethyl, ammonium bromide. Now here, which is to be considered as cationic detergent, because this bromide, which comes out in the form of Br minus, and the positive charge is developed on the nitrogen atom, so which is to be considered as cationic detergent. Next, question number 152. A tertiary butyl carbocation is more stable than secondary butyl carbocation. This is because this can be explained based on hyperconjugation. Let us consider tertiary butyl carbocation. This is tertiary butyl carbocation. Now alpha hydrogen atoms involves in hyperconjugation. Now this is the carbon atom bearing the positive charge. Now these are the alpha carbon atoms. Now 3 plus 3 plus 3, total 9 alpha hydrogen atoms are present. So 9 hyperconjugative structures are possible with tertiary butyl carbocation. Now let us consider secondary butyl carbocation. That is, positive charge has to be present on secondary carbon atom. Now this is the structure of the secondary butyl carbocation. Now this is the carbon atom bearing the positive charge. Now this is alpha carbon and this is alpha carbon. Totally 5 hydrogen atoms are attached to alpha carbon atoms. Now 5 hyperconjugative structures are possible. Now the structure with more number of hyperconjugative structures is more stable. So tertiary butyl carbocation is more stable due to more number of hyperconjugative structures.